معرفة.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. In this lesson, let us discuss about treasury. Okay, let us take an Islamic bank. So if this is an Islamic bank, the Islamic bank receives liquidity generally from three sources. One is, for example, customers' deposits. The other is from interbank deposits. The third from shareholders' fund. So from these three sources, generally a bank receives liquidity, meaning to say the cash. Now, once the bank receives the cash needs to be placed, the cash needs to be invested to generate profit. Now, in every bank, the department which manages, which becomes the center point, which becomes the source where the fund gets collected, is nothing but the treasury. So this is the treasury department, for example, wherein all the funds gets collected and pooled. Now, a very important duty on the treasury department is to manage the liquidity and to ensure that liquidity is available for current and future obligations, meaning to say that the liquidity is available, for example, to address whenever customer wants to withdraw money from the bank. Liquidity is available to repay the financing which the bank has taken from other banks, so on and so forth. At the same time, the treasury department has to ensure that the liquidity is invested effectively so that it generates profits, and those profits are given back to the various entities who have invested in the bank. So the two main responsibilities on the treasury department of any bank, and in specific an Islamic bank, are number one, liquidity management, and risk management. So the two main important functions of a treasury department is to manage the liquidity and also to manage the risk of the liquidity. And to fulfill its responsibility, there are various instruments which have been structured for the liquidity placement as well as to mitigate the risk. And in our lesson, we will discuss what are the products specifically designed to address the liquidity management issues, and also what are the products designed specifically to mitigate risk.